Hey there, how's it going? Today, I'm about to present to you 2012 Mazda 6. In this video, I'm going to show you the entire Soul 6 service car. So guys, here's the key. Let's start the engine. Let it run for a while. Basically, your lock and unlock button to unlock and to lock. Also, this car comes equipped with the aftermarket remote start, remote alarm. Beautiful exterior. It's just a Japanese princess. Extremely reliable, fun to drive. Look at this beauty. Smoke and pet-free interior. Aftermarket rain guards. Some damage right here. Alright. Wide opening doors. Two-tone interior. This car has 6 airbags. Actually, this is a base trim. Multifunctional steering wheel. Not bad. Alrighty, let's hop it in. Ignition. In order to start the engine, put your foot on the clutch and then the start button right there. Quite easy. Nice. Very quiet and reliable engine. Let's turn on the air conditioning, because today is extremely hot day outside. 30 degrees Celsius. Loud horn. Barefoot steering wheel, manual tilt, and telescopic. As you can see, nice. Right now, it's on headlight, front rear fog lights, high beam, Soul search lights right here in the center. Air conditioning is ice cold. It's a good sign, definitely. This car has 6-speed manual transmission. That's a huge plus. This particular has 153,650 kilometers on the clock. Not bad. All four windows in this car are fully automatic in both direction, up and down. As you can see. Not bad. This plastic looks like a black one, but actually it's a brown, soft touch plastic. Power window lock and power steering mirrors. As an option on upper trim, power folding feature is available. Alrighty guys, right now let's open the hood and take a look at the exterior of this car. Alright, let's open the hood. Fuel tank release. All you need to do to open the trunk is quite easy. Pull this lever. That's pretty much it. Fuel cap release. Alrighty. This car missing power moonroof. In this case, rear light doors. SkyActiv technology. Premium under fuel only, of course. Required. All metal, dual polished exhaust pipes, beautiful, aftermarket air parking assist, of course, yeah, duh. And license plate lights right there. A lot of chrome. Mazda 6. SkyActiv technology. Excellent coefficient of drag, that's for sure. Main rivals for this car is a Nissan Tiana, Honda Accord, and of course Toyota Camry, maybe VW Passat, Skoda Superb, Chevrolet Malibu, and I believe Mitsubishi Galant. Multi-spoke aluminum rims. 17-inch tires measuring 225/55. Front ventilated disc brakes and rear solid disc brakes. Bridgestone Transit tires. Independent McPherson strut suspension with Untrouble up front and multi-expansion out back. Right now, let's take a good look underneath of this car. Manually folding stereo mirrors like so, and your turn signal light is right here. Beautiful exterior, absolutely gorgeous. And there is no damage or imperfection on the front. Some cracks right here on the windshield and right there. Xenon project headlights, low beam, high beam reflector, halogen, and aftermarket fog lights. Head washers right here. Some imperfection on the chrome, as you can see, it's pretty common. It happens with age. Some imperfection on the paint. Alrighty guys, right now let's take a look underneath this beautiful car. Under the hood of Mazda 6, we have inline 4, 16.5, dual head cam, natural aspirated engine, 2 liter. It produced 150 horsepower with SkyActiv technology. Very quiet engine. For the aftermarket alarm, your brake fluid, your air filter, of course your coolant, washer fluid reservoir, brakes, ESP, ABS, and that's pretty much it. Fuel economy is surprisingly pretty good. It's pretty reliable, all I can say. Awesome engine indeed. Also 2.5 liter is available, produce 192 horsepower. some imperfection right here. Need polishing, that's for sure. And a crack on the windshield. And here. And here's some damage. Let's take a look underneath once again. Right now it's a good look at the rear suspension.
Exhaust system.
Alrighty guys, right now, take a good look the exterior. Let's take a good look the interior portion. The most interesting part of this beautiful car. Very nice attention to the details. That is soft touch stitching, soft touch right here, fake aluminum, soft plastic, your speakers, search area, and of course door lights. Tire pressure 17-inch rims, 225/85. Also you can put 18-inch and even 19-inch rims. Manual adjustment, of course, seat high, sliding, incline, and little lumbar support right there. All season floor mats plus the six, as you can see. And here's your gas pedal and brake, clutch, OBD right there. Storage compartment for the driver. Have headlights, traction, and tire pressure monitoring system. Fit and finish is just perfect in this car. True Japanese quality. Alrighty guys, right now, let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. Around 4000 RPM when you're not moving. definitely not bad. And here's your light indicator controls, your intermittent wiper controls, stick and drop buttons. You can increase and decrease the volume, and your mute button. For the driver information system. Like I mentioned before, this particular has 153,650 kilometers in it. Distance to MT basically your range, 151 kilometers, maybe more, I can tell. Average and current fuel economy, elapsed time, of course. Your speed, that's it. Easy to read gauges. Soft touch plastic for the aftermarket alarm, and right here for the aftermarket rear parking assist. Manual lithium rearview mirror, as you can see. And here's your stereo system with auxiliary and USB integration right there, plus your 12-volt power socket. Some storage compartment, very deep size. Soft touch with stitching. This color right here, C control buttons folder, F on, you have bass adjustment. For the stock audio, sounds pretty good. Treble, beta, balance, sweeping, 6 customizable stations. Can increase and decrease the volume. Text, scanning, USB, auxiliary, CD, FM. Very simple. Indeed. Turned off and turned on. Down here you can find your adjustment for the clock, hours, minutes, switching between different modes. That's it. Heated seats, 3-stage for the driver and basically for the passenger, high, medium, low enough. That's pretty much it. Easy to use air conditioning on a top trim, dual zone fully automatic climate control is available. Cycle, temperature adjustment, and of course your different modes, ready for us. That's it. Down here you can find your power supply, 12 volt, some storage compartment, easy access for your phone, and of course this silky smooth 6-speed manual transmission. Reverse, rear parking assist. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, not bad. Short shifter, e-brake, somewhere right here. It's barely noticeable. For the aftermarket alarm, as you can see. Very convenient, especially winter time. 2 convenient cup holders. I mean, this shade is obviously broken. And apparently some storage compartment. That's it. Very good visibility, indeed. Sound visors, but there is no illumination on the top trim. Illumination is available. Warning. Of course, all handle. Map lights. And sunglass container. It's also padded. Very nice size. Same storage for this side. That's it. Side curtain airbags. Overall build quality and all the materials are very nice. Soft touch. This car is really fun to drive. Really. With my 6'3" stature, those seats are very nice. Legroom is more than enough. Thigh support is pretty good. And shoulder room is okay. Definitely. Not bad. Right now, let's check back seats, shall we? And of course, with my 6'3" stature, it's quite easy to get in and out. As you can see, back windows are fully tinted. It's broken. And actually, the doors are not standing in a hold position any longer. As you can see, it's broken. That's it. It's pretty easy to fix right there. Holder. And materials to carry over, as you can see. Soft touch leather. Asafix system is available for the back seats and chest anchors. I'm going to show you how to fold 60-foot split back seats. Quite easy. That's it. One hand operation. Very simple. Like so. Three adjustable headrests, as you can see. Let's hop in. Legroom is not an issue at all for me. Headroom is pretty good. Shoulderroom is okay. Some storage pockets right there. Right there. Almost like completely flat floor, but there is no vents, no heated seats on top trim. Those options are available. And in the center, you can find your very convenient armrest with two lovely cup holders. Of course, on top trim, 10 airbags available, plus your sunshade. All handles got hook. This one is broken. Happens. Look at this beautiful Japanese interior. Seats are very comfortable. Actually, Takata Recall Company. Please check that twice. Their airbags, as you can see. Right now, guys, let's check trunk space, shall we? Trunk, surprisingly, not very huge. As you can see, not extra floor mats. Actually, those are Austin's floor mats. Not that you see on the driver's side and the passenger side. For the subwoofer and for the amplifier, I believe. Illumination, trunk illumination right there. Jack tools, and we are here to find a full-size spare tire, Bridgestone, temporary use only. Bridgestone tires, that's it. You can barely fit, like, I don't know, your bicycle or something like that. Very tiny. Convenient handle to close trunk lid. That's it. Some elements are falling apart in this car, surprisingly, but it happens. You can find the same manual adjustment for the passenger seat, minus seat height. Of course, your glove box is not lockable, it's not so big. I believe your manuals right there. Yep. Service wheel. So, Russian specification, of course. Thank you. like this car lasts forever. I mean, look at this Hummer H2. It's just a beauty. And this car lasts forever. Extremely reliable, well built, fun to drive. Unfortunately, MPS series is not available anymore, like the previous generation. Mazda Performance Series, Mazda 3 MPS, and Mazda 6 MPS. Alrighty, guys. Hope you enjoy my in-depth tour of this 2012 Mazda 6. Thanks for watching, thanks for sharing, for subscribing, truly appreciate it. Take care, guys.